So before we even start the roster update predictions, just know if you press that join button, you become a member of the channel, and with that, exclusive perks come at you. So one of the exclusive perks is I go ahead and put out my Excel sheet, and it's color-coded so you know which players I think are good long-term investments, which players I believe are current investments that after the roster update, if they do get upgraded, you should sell, and then players that I believe are way too high to invest in. We're going to be doing this quick because I have a lot of players I want to discuss, so I'm going to tell you the overall prediction and then whether or not I think you should hold for Diamond or whatever that upgrade tier that is coming next is going to be. So we're going to start it off with Alvarez. Alvarez has been hitting extremely well. He's hitting over 500 in the last 7 days, and then, or 7 games, I should say. And then in his last 14 games, he's hitting over 1400, or not 1400, 400, excuse me. I see him going up to an 83 to 84. I believe that he has a possibility of going diamond, but that's going to be long-term investment. He's going to have to stay consistent with his hitting in order to go diamond because he's a designated hitter, so that fielding you see right there is never going to get upgraded unless he starts playing the field, which seems very unlikely. Next up is going to be the man from the Bronx that has been putting the smackdown on all baseballs, and that's Giancarlo Stanton. Now, Giancarlo Stanton, he has a good chance of going diamond. Right now, I have it as the flip of a coin, 50% chance. And the reasoning behind it is his slugging numbers aren't too hot against lefties, so I feel like they're gonna decrease that. And then his contact and power versus right, I feel like that's definitely getting increased. But at the same time, what SDS might do, and this will be grimy if they go ahead and do that, is they'll see his fielding and say, hey, he has been playing designated hitter all year this year. And then in the previous two seasons, he hasn't really been playing the outfield, so his fielding should not be that high. So let's go ahead, decrease his fielding attribute, and then balance out those hitting attributes to how they should actually look, and that will remain him a gold. Now, I don't believe SDS is grimy enough to do that, but it is a possibility I want you all to keep in mind. That's why I have Giancarlo Stanton as a 50%. We're going to the, I believe, Diamondbacks now for Josh Rojas. Josh Rojas, I see everything being increased. Long-term investment for silver, I think he has a 70% chance of going silver. What really helps him out is that gold defense that he has. So if he continues hitting as he's currently hitting, keeps that consistency, he's gonna go silver. I see him going up to 70, 71, 72 overall, somewhere along that range, and then I can see him continue to get upgrades if he stays consistent with the way he's doing. Chicago, the Brizzo company, we have Chris Bryant. Chris Bryant could get an upgrade this week. I see all his hitting attributes getting an increase, and then the contact numbers, it's minimal, so not that much, probably +3 for each of the contact numbers. I see him going up to an 83, 84 overall. He is a hold for diamond, so long-term investment at the same time, and I do believe that he has a 60% chance, if he stays consistent with his hitting, to go diamond. Now, if he increases his batting average against right-handers, I see him going diamond without a problem. But right now, he's struggling. He's not the best. Marcus, he as well is someone that I could see going gold. I see his contact being increased and then the power numbers minimally being increased as well. I have him at a 90% chance to go gold. If he doesn't go gold, he's hitting a 79 overall, and then you should go and invest on him on Friday because I am 100% certain that as he continues his hitting streaks and he's over here hitting home runs, hitting for power, he's going to get the attributes that he does require to go gold, and he will eventually go gold as well. Another long-term investment, and that is one that I don't have it high, is Rafael Devers. Rafael Devers, I don't see anything happening to his contact versus right. His contact versus left, though, and then his power numbers, I do see them being increased. I think he's going to go up to an 82 overall because there's only so much you can increase to his power versus right. And then his power versus left, I don't see it being increased too much. So an 82, 83 overall is my prediction. Hold for diamond. I have him at a 25% chance because in order for him to go diamond, he's going to have to increase those slugging numbers against left-handers big time. Because third basemen, they depend on some fielding, and him having common fielding is not helping him out at all. Another good long-term investment, could be a current investment, is Jorge Polanco. He's selling for underneath 100 stubs. I see his contact versus left increasing, and then at the same time, he's going to get both right-handed attributes decreased, and then his power versus left increasing some. So he either has the chance of staying as a 74 overall or going up to a 75 overall. Now, I have him as a hold for silver long-term because I do believe he has a 60% chance of obtaining that silver mark. Texas Rangers time, and his name is Falefa. So, Falefa, he has been hitting really well against right-handers. He has been struggling against left-handers, although. I see him going up to 79, 80 overall. The diamond defense really helps him out. Hold for gold, 80% chance. Nolan Arenado, we're tackling him next. And this is someone that I believe that prematurely SDS went ahead and downgraded. I think he's going to shoot back up to a 90 overall, which means that he's going to get more expensive once again. And since he's going to get more expensive once again, if you have the stubs, he wouldn't be someone. If you have the stubs to buy him, he would be someone that you buy and then you just hold on to him because his price is most likely going to shoot right back up to what it was previously. The next one from the Boston Red Sox is going to be Xander Bogaerts. Now, I've been telling you guys to invest in Xander Bogaerts since he was like 2K stubs, since my first roster update prediction. I told you all, he is the best shortstop, in my opinion, in the majors when it comes to hitting. He's going to 100% go diamond. If it's not this week, it's going to be the next roster update. I see him going up to an 86, 87 overall and all his hitting attributes going up. Xander Bogaerts right now looks a little bit too expensive to actually invest in currently, but if you got in early, you're gonna make some stubs. Nicholas Castellanos, another long-term investment. I have him at a 50% chance to actually go diamond because he actually plays the field. So SDS might be generous and give him some fielding somewhere down the line in order to actually make him a diamond, probably shoot that fielding up to a 60. Now, what I see being upgraded this week is his contact versus right and then power numbers against both sides, 83, 84 overall. I do once again believe that he does have the potential of going diamond as he has hit diamond previously in last year's MLB The Show. Jared, I see his contact number and power number versus right-handers going up. Versus left-handers, I see it being decreased. I think that the numbers going up versus right-handers are going to be substantial enough to push him to gold. He's a long-term hold for gold. I have him 100% going gold, especially now that Albert Pujols is no longer playing in the Angels. That spot is his. Josh Naylor, someone else similar to Jared, I see his lefty numbers going down, his righty numbers going up. I have him as a hold for silver, 60%. I think if he does get an upgrade, it's a 74 to 75 overall. Adolis Garcia, his price out of everyone we've talked about is definitely a little bit too high. I would go as far as to say someone you shouldn't even look at, to be honest. Now, he does have the possibility of going gold. I have him at a 50% chance. So if he continues his hitting the way he's currently hitting, he's going to have that good chance of going gold. So if you're investing in him right now in terms of long term, it's going to be a good investment if you're not looking to sell him at silver, but hold for a chance of him going gold. That's going to be a great investment in my opinion. Jesse Winker from the Cincinnati Reds. Jesse Winker, right now he's selling for under 1,000 stubs, so you can probably make some good money if you start buying him now, and I believe he's going to be one of the only golds from the Cincinnati Reds, since I think Luis Castillo is dropping out of gold this week, so his price should be even better. I see his right-handed attributes going up, left-handed attributes decreasing just a bit. He either goes to 79 to 80 overall, hold for gold 90%. If it doesn't happen this week, it's definitely going to happen down the line. So he's someone you want to also invest in. When it comes to Cedric Mullins, he only hits lefty now, so they took off his switch hitting finally. I see his contact versus right, all hitting attributes are going up basically. I see him going up to 73, 74, 75. I think he definitely has that hold for silver at 100%, and it's gonna happen this week or get pretty close to happening this week. If it doesn't happen this week, then he's someone that on Friday, you're gonna go ahead and empty the bank on because you want him long-term to invest in to go silver. Does he have a chance at gold? I think it's unlikely, but still possible, probably at a 35% to 40% chance since he does have good fielding. Ramon Laureano. Now, his contact versus right and power versus right have been abysmal this season. He is absolutely trash. But versus left, he's increased both numbers. I think he can get an upgrade to an 83 overall hold for diamond at a 65% chance, because as soon as he figures it out against right-handers, all he has to do is hit above 250, I would say, maybe 275, and he'll go diamond because his fielding is what really carries him. And then last but not least, for the hitter section, we have Miguel Rojas. Miguel Rojas, a good investment right now, like a ton of these players. He's really carried by his defense. His defense being diamond really helps him out. I see his contact versus right being decreased just a little bit, and then all other hitting attributes being increased. I see him going up to an 80 overall. I have him as a hold for gold 100%. And now we'll go to the pitching. We got John Means. He just threw a no-hitter and his price is inflated because of that, but another good reason to invest in him is he'll be the only gold from the Baltimore Orioles, so down the line eventually his price is going to continue going up. I have him as a hold for gold 95% chance with all his pitching attributes going up. Dylan Cease from the Chicago White Sox, have him as a long-term investment. I think he can go silver. So this roster update, if he does get an upgrade, I see a 72 to 73 overall upgrade, but long term, believe he's a silver, so make sure you invest in him as well. Zach Wheeler also selling for underneath 1K. The last 14 days, he's pitched twice and he's had two good outings. I think you could give his hit per nine, K per nine, and walk per nine all increases. Home run per nine probably wouldn't get touched. I see him going back to gold 100%. If it's not this roster update, it's going to be down the line. Then the man who also has thrown a no-hitter this year, Carlos, I also see him going up to a 79 or 80 overall. He's another player that I would say, if he doesn't hit gold this roster update, you invest in him and then you hold for gold. Anthony from the Cincinnati Reds, or actually, excuse me, from the San Francisco Giants. I'm positive he played for the Reds previously, although, or maybe I'm just mistaking him for someone else. 77 to 78 overall. Now, I say he's a hold for gold at a 65% chance. So you're not investing in him in order to sell him as a silver. You're investing in him to hold on to him long term. So when he does go gold, you either quick sell him or you sell him in the community market. I think that he definitely has the possibility, especially since he's been pitching very well. If he continues that, the last two games he's pitched well. If he continues that, then he does have the possibility. Cole Irvin is someone that I think is a little bit too overpriced right now to invest in. He's a 65, 66, 67 overall projected. If he does get a roster update, hold for bronze 100%. And the reason he might be a little bit overpriced right now is because the Oakland Athletics don't have any diamond anymore. So that makes all the cards that are below in terms of tiers skyrocket in price as well. Brian Abreu from the Houston Astros. I think he's a long-term investment. He's selling for pretty cheap right now. If he does get upgraded, it's going to be to 63, 64 overall. He's a hold for bronze, and then he has a chance of going silver since he hasn't pitched at all in the previous seasons. So if he locks in and figures it out, then his overall is going to skyrocket as the season continues. I think he's a long-term investment. If you're able to buy him as a common cheaply, you'll be able to invest in a ton of him and then hold him for bronze. Once he goes bronze, you'll be able to hold him for silver, and then if he goes silver, you'll be making a lot of stubs compared to what you originally bought him in. Alex Claudio. Now, with the Angels, he's turned his season around, or he's turned his career around as of right now. Definitely see him as a 63 to 64 overall, so I don't see him jumping to bronze just yet, but he's someone that I do believe you should hold for bronze at an 80% chance. Believe he's a long-term investment, just like Brian Abreu. Springs is going to be up next. Jeffrey Springs, another long-term investment. I see all his attributes going up except for his home run per nine, 63 to 64 overall, just like the previous guys, but he's a hold for bronze 100%. Does he have a chance of going silver? I think he does, but it's gonna be very unlikely. Matt Barnes, if you get the chance, make sure you invest in him as well, because Matt Barnes is going to get all his pitching attributes going up, 81 to 82 overall. He's a hold for gold 100%. And if he continues pitching the way he does, I have him at a 50% chance to actually go diamond this season as well. Now we're going to talk about a diamond that deserves an upgrade, and that's going to be Aroldis Chapman. I think that he's a good investment right now because as he continues to get upgrades, his price is going to continue going up, and his walks per nine this year are amazing. So that walk per nine is 100% going to get touched. I think he's going to go up to an 87 overall, and he has a 65% chance of entering that high-end diamond tier, which is a 90 overall and above. Next up, it's gonna be from the Detroit Tigers, I believe, Milwaukee Brewers actually, excuse me, JP. JP, I told you all to invest in both of the previous roster updates. Now he's getting the respect he deserves. Definitely see him going up to bronze. He's a hold for bronze 100%. Do I believe that you should hold for silver? He's not really a young kid. He's starting to figure it all out right now. Hold for silver, I'm not 100% positive. I probably put him at a 25 to 30% chance. So I would go ahead and sell him once he does go bronze. Now this is a kid that I 100% have told you all to invest in because he's gonna go diamond this year, and I have that at a 100% chance. If he doesn't go diamond this roster update, he's gonna go diamond down the line. So make sure you invest in him right now, especially if his price drops on Friday. Project him to go to an 85 to 86 overall, but long term, I project him to go diamond 100%. Then last but not least, we have ourselves from previously the Miami Marlins to now the Arizona Diamondbacks, Caleb Smith. I see everything increasing except for his walks per nine, him going up to 72, 73 overall, and then long term, him being a hold for silver. And that's going to be it for all of the predictions we have for this week's roster update. If you did end up enjoying it, please make sure to hit that like button, that subscribe button. Don't forget to follow me on all socials at Blademus. Turn on the channel notifications. If you would like to become a member, feel free to do so. And now that I'm going to be finishing school, I'll be able to make these lists much more frequently as well. But with that being said, have a blessed day and night. Stay positive, stay safe, stay blessed, and I will catch you all on the next one. Peace out.